Hey, it's Jamar Bevel here, and I'm going to be doing today my very first tutorial. I'm going to be doing it in DaVinci Resolve. We're going to look at some color grading techniques and just my overall workflow of color grading. I have some footage I'm going to show you here. And I know I've been behind on my videos a little bit, but I'm going to get back around. I've got green screen stuff coming up. Color grading, editing stuff, and I'm going to be doing tons of tutorials in HitFilm Express 3. Look out for that. And I'm going to get going. Let's go. I made this. I had a few friends come over and do some filming for a short film. So this is a test. Here we go. Alright, so that was the video. We are going to be recreating some of the color grading in this shot, color grading, color correcting, and let's get going. Hope you enjoyed the video there. There is a decent amount of grain in there. I don't know why. There's something up with my camera, but I will get that figured out. But let's start off with, I like this shot here. Let's start off with this. So I'm in DaVinci Resolve 12, the light version. And, alright. So in DaVinci, I normally like to have like a regular node that is not being used for just everything, just to keep it safe. And then I just add a serial node. The nodes inside DaVinci Resolve, I normally just add serial nodes and just keep going. I don't do all the fancy stuff, but let's look at the scopes over here. So for the shot, I want to bring the shadows down, get some more contrast in there, but I don't want to make it like a bright scene, so let me have it like that. I like to have a lot of pop in it, and I add a lot of nodes, so I'm gonna just bring up the contrast over here a lot to this. I like seeing that, and I'm gonna bring the saturation down. It looks a little bit better with desaturated a little bit more. This is supposed to be rough and like kind of saddish, so I want to keep it in that general area. So we did that. Let's I like to add vignettes to a lot of the work sometimes. As far as dark scenes, they can really add on. In this guide here, I'm gonna show you a little bit on just a little few nodes. So this is a mask I created here. I'm going to invert it so we can get a vignette effect here. I normally just bring the highlights down and a little bit of the gamma, and then I make it feather it enough. So that I think we're getting closer. I'm gonna add another node here. Just darken this whole area, this general section, because his head is obviously not in that area, so we can kind of give him some more focus room. Whenever you're doing these types of masks, always kind of keep it a little, don't go extreme with it. Alright. Let me just feather this out a little bit more here. Now, I'm Now I'm going to add some color contrast. When the grain went away, a decent amount of the grain went away. But yeah, so let me just add some yellows in the gamma. I want to keep it dark though. Maybe on the greenish side a little bit. Let me see. That looks kind of nice there. And if the skin tones start getting messed up, just add a mask and track it as far as the skin tones. Always keep the skin tones correct. You never want to mess those up. That's one of the worst things you can do. It's terrible. Maybe a little bit more contrast. I like that. I'm starting, that's the original, and this is a new one. Let me see if I can add some more warmth, maybe more warmth. No, make it a little bit cooler. So I'm gonna make it a little bit cooler. I'm gonna add another node, and then I'm gonna do a log. And then bring the shadows down in a log and then have it so it's dark like that. There we go. I don't want to bring them down too low. There. Alright, we got something. This is looking really fancy. This is good. Wow. Yeah, original. Final. I like that. And when I'm in DaVinci, I just hit the clips and pop it back up. I want to work with, take this shot, for example. So there's a lot of things going on in this shot here. Well, it seems that the grain is really there in the hair of this actor here. Let me start off by bringing the shadows down. I'm going to crush them. I normally don't recommend crushing the shadows super far. I mean, unless it's a really dark, gritty scene. I have CineStyle installed on my Canon T2i, so it's a little bit more flat, but still, I like to keep them decent, but for this scene, I'm just going to crush them. Let's bring the highlights down a bit. It's a little bright. I don't really want it bright. Oh, wait, sorry, I made a mistake. Didn't change it back to primary wheels. Log wheels are less, they're more straightforward, and primary is more general. Like, it doesn't affect as much. I'm just gonna bring the shadows down. Okay. I'm looking at the scope right now. Bring the highlights down. I want her lips to kind of pop, so it's okay to add extra saturation. I'm gonna add contrast. A little too much. Alright, so I'm gonna add a vignette. This now. My computer's acting up a little bit. It's lagging. I don't know why. Normally doesn't do this. This is my first time recording, so I don't know. It could be that. Bring down the highlights. Oh, and thank you to all the new subscribers. from the last week or so. Yep, so I upload videos every week. I try, at least. Yeah. Gonna just feather that a little bit more. Now we have this. Her face. When I'm doing composition, I normally try keeping the actors in the same general space, so she doesn't really move across this area. I like to keep it very just the same. So I'm gonna add another one of these. And I'm going to darken this area. I wanna really emphasize and focus on the face area. Okay. Gotta bring the highlights down in that section. Okay, so here's the problem. Now you're starting to see this like halo of a circle type thing. So I'm just gonna make the gradient a little bit bigger and then make the overall mask larger. And that looks a little bit better. Let me just zoom out here. Oh, right, that's partially the vignette, too. I didn't realize that. Okay. Let's add... for some reason, as far as these shots, I'm liking a lot of contrast for some reason. But adding pop and contrast really does help to it. I'm gonna decrease the highlights a bit. Now, so that was mostly, I already passed the color correcting stage. It's already at color grading, but I want to make this really dark and gritty, kind of like Tron, maybe Tron Legacy type deal going on. I want to make it on the bluish side, but then also keeping some warmth. I'm going to show you how to do a mask here. So just add a mask, and I'm going to track it, because her face, I want it to pop a little bit more and just be more defined. So I'm going to have her face here, and she doesn't move very much, but I'm just going to track it anyway. I suggest starting it from the beginning, and you just put the mask over your area and hit play, and it will track. It doesn't take long, it only takes a second. A little sick here. I'm going to be doing some more live stuff where I'm going to be in it. I'm going to be making a short film soon about, it's similar to video games. It's going to be in collaboration with a few other YouTubers. So be ready for that. All right, our track is done. Now I'm going to take some of these shadows out of her face and keep it the same, but not going too far. Keep a little bit in there. So this, let me feather it a little bit more. I don't know. My computer's really acting slow today. Wow. Alright, so before that, after. So there's a little bit of a difference there. And I'm just going to add a final node and just a little bit more contrast. Not that much. I lowered it. I think I like that right there. and maybe add, have less color, I think, in the face, lower the saturation. Whoops, a little too far. There, I like that. So I think this is a pretty good looking final shot. Before and after. I like that. Looks cool, like a blockbuster horror film type thing. I have two shots that I have color graded to demonstrate for you. I think this will call it a day. I will probably do more color grading stuff and overall DaVinci Resolve tutorials if you ask for that. Next week or even tomorrow, I'm going to upload a green screen tutorial.